So hello, everyone. I'm Kathleen. I work as a program manager at Microsoft on the Edge team. More specifically, I help maintain the Edge developer side. Think of like issue trackers, status page, etc. But I also focus on trying to help web developers and move the web forward. So today, I'm really excited to be here and introduce you to a new project called Sonar. But before I do, let's talk a little bit about web development. So as you know, being a good web developer is kind of hard. Like, you have to know about basics, HTML, JavaScript, CSS, but then you go into things like security, performance, accessibility, progressive web apps, responsive web design, etc. Libraries, frameworks, a lot of frameworks. And everything moves really, really fast. So you have to refresh your knowledge every few months. And not only that, but it's impossible to keep track with all the changes, and not only changes, but all the best practices in all those fields. Furthermore, to make things even more worse, developers try to search for quick answers. And usually the place where they find the quick answers are not the best. Like Stack Overflow may have the most upvoted answer, but it may not be the correct one, or it may just suggest using jQuery. And with blog posts, it's even worse because you don't have a voting system and you don't know if it's the correct answer or that best practice is no, it's an anti-pattern now. On top of that, we have a lot of tools, and some are good, some are bad. Developers know about some, may not know about others. It takes time to know the tools, configure them, etc. So we started thinking at Microsoft about all of these problems, and we made a prototype, and that eventually ended up being Sonar. Sonar is a linting tool for the web, basically a tool that will allow you to get all to figure out all the problems in your application, like web app, like a web application or a site. Even performance, security, everything that I said before. So it's a, it takes care of all of those things. To put it in a more fine way, the intent with Sonar is to help developers, regardless of their skill level, build better site by writing better code, educate developers, because this is a huge problem, and get rid of obsolete product. And by this, we think we can help move the web platform in the right direction. In terms of like development, what we want with Sonar is to be community-driven with up-to-date best practices, flexible enough to be integrated into any development workflow, and be easy to configure, contribute, extend, and evolve. Let's talk a little bit about code. So right now, we have a command line tool. This is the package name. You can use npm, yarn, whatever package manager you want. Once you install the package, you need to configure it. The configuration can go either in a sonar.rc file or in a package.json under sonar.config. It looks like this, but you don't have to write it. There is a generator. It will ask you some tools. It will generate the configuration file. This is how it looks after you run Sonar. So it just scans the website, tells you all the errors. And let's talk a little bit about architecture, just to understand how Sonar works. So there are three types of components. First off, it's connector. Connector is basically an abstraction that allows Sonar to connect, obviously, to browsers and things such as browsers. And why I say things such as browsers is because the thing they might connect to may not be a real browser. So for example, we currently have two implementations. One is on top of JS DOM. And for people that don't know, JS DOM is just a pure JavaScript implementation of some standards that closely emulate a browser. Then we have one on top of Chrome DevTools protocol. We're working on an Edge one, and others will follow. The reason why we have multiple ones is because we want to be, Sonar to be a cross-platform, a cross-browser thing, because the real world is not just one browser. Next up, rules. Rules are the tests that Sonar runs. From the beginning, we made the decision to not reinvent the wheel. So when there are tools that do an amazing job, we're going to integrate them into Sonar. So we already do that with certain tools like Axe for accessibility, SSL Labs, and others. When tools don't do a great job, we're going to try to contribute. And if it doesn't make sense for us, we're just going to write our own tools. In general, when it comes to rules, we want them to concentrate on a specific problem. go really deep and not blindly check for things, because those tools don't just offer you the security, but usually they just miss a lot of stuff. When it makes sense, they should be configurable and they should be context aware. I usually give an example, but here I don't have time, but rules can be configured at the high level. So you can say it's an error and you will fail your build. An error, it will just print the error message, but it will not return to you, it will return with the status code of 0 and off if you don't care about the rule. Now, these are high level configurations, but rules can come with their own configuration. So documents modes were a thing in old IEs. This rule will basically check for the header, but you can also configure it to check for the meta tag. But in that case, we'll check for all the error cages, all the edge cases related to the meta tag. But it will still be smart enough to know that the meta tag can be overwritten by the header. So it goes really deep into all that kind of stuff. So I've talked about configurations and going really deep, but I didn't talk about context aware. And I'm going to give you one example. There are many. So Sonar offers you to specify the targeted browsers. And in this case, this rule that only applies for all IEs will not complain about not having the meta tag or the header. Or if it sees the header or the meta tag, it will say, hey, remove it or not send the header. So it's smart enough to know in what context they're run. So you don't need to even turn them off. They know what to do. And finally, we have formatters. They are responsible for displaying the result. So you can have the result like pure JSON or in a more beautiful form or even code where exactly the error is. Now, we're really keen on having good documentation because we've seen developers want just rapid access to them. So every rule will have one or two pages that explain all the edge cases really fast and also resources where users can read more about it that are that as a community, we decide are the best things. Core versus plugins. All of these components can be in the core or in the plugin. The idea is what benefits the masses will be in the core, otherwise in the plugin. Also, we want Sonar not only to be used for errors, but also to enforce certain things. So if you're a company, you want to kind of restrict the JavaScript bundle to a certain side or have certain elements in a certain order, you can write your own rules and apply them in your company. Why all of this, why have complexity, but also allow to configure things, is because we want developers to make informed decisions. Because at the end of the day, they are the ones that best understand what they're building. We just want to stay out of the way and allow them to best build whatever they want. The future, so I've talked a lot about the present. So we want Sonar to be, so right now we're working on the command line tool and stabilizing the API. This project is very new, it's like just a few months. But in the near future, because we want Sonar to be helpful for every developer regardless of the skill level, we're going to have an online scanner so you don't have to install anything. And with your permission, we can store the results and show you over time how your site evolved, or you can compare with other scans, like 90% of the scans pass this rule, why aren't you? Other thing is, we want Sonar to be useful during all the development process, not only at the end, because certain things such as accessibility are kind of, if you're introducing them at the end, it won't work. So we're going to integrate them with editors, like VS Code will be the first one, probably. Next up, open source. This project is open source. It's under the JS Foundation, so we donated it. And also, before we even open sourced it, we knew this is not going to be successful if it's just a single vendor thing. So we started at that point discussing this project with other browser vendors, such as the teams behind Mozilla, Chrome, and Samsung Internet. They are all on board. They're very excited about the project. If you are excited and want to engage, best thing to do is go to our website, sonarwall.com, GitHub, our organization, all the code is open source. You can find issues or what we're thinking in the future to build. Gitter is where we hang out, and this is our Twitter. Follow us. If you have more questions or you want stickers, come talk to me. Thanks, and let's build a linting tool for the web.